Welcome to our deep dive. Today we're going to be looking at Apache Lucene. Ever wonder how search engines like Google can sift through like billions of web pages in just like a blink? Or how you can find exactly what you're looking for on Amazon? Well, Lucene is often behind those crazy fast searches.
Yeah, that's right. It's this open source Java library, which means anyone can use it and even modify it. It's not a search engine itself, though. Yeah. Think of it more like a toolkit for building your own custom search solutions.
Gotcha. So instead of building an entire search engine myself from scratch, I can use Lucene to take care of all that complicated stuff under the hood.
Exactly. And, you know, the really cool thing is even if you never actually use Lucene directly in your work, understanding how it works can make you like a much better developer overall.
Okay. How so?
Well, it's all about taking those computer science fundamentals we all learn and applying them to real world problems,
right,
like storing and retrieving tons of information super efficiently.
All right. I'm listening. What kind of fundamental concepts are we talking about here? I'm always down to improve my problem solving skills.
Okay, well, let's start with the heart of Lucene, the inverted index.
Okay.
Have you ever thought about, like, the index at the back of a textbook? You know, it tells you what page to find a specific word on.
Yeah.
An inverted index basically does something similar, but on a much larger scale.
Right.
It maps terms to the documents they appear in.
So instead of scanning every single word in a document, it's got, like, this roadmap to where specific words are.
Exactly. And it's this roadmap that makes searching super fast, even when you're dealing with huge amounts of data.
Yeah.
This idea of efficient data storage and retrieval, it's crucial in all kinds of software development, not just search.
I see. That's really clever.
Yeah.
So we've got our documents, and Lucene builds this inverted index. But what happens before that? Mm-hmm. How does it know what to put into the index in the first place?
Right. So that's where tokenization and analysis come in. Imagine you're making a cake.
Yeah.
You wouldn't just chuck all the ingredients in at once, right?
Yeah.
You'd like chop, measure, prepare them first. Tokenization is kind of like chopping the text into smaller pieces, usually words, so Lucene can work with them.
Gotcha. So it's like breaking the text down into more manageable pieces.
Right. And then analysis is like taking those ingredients and refining them even further.
Okay.
Like stemming, which is reducing words to their root form.
Yeah.
Or removing common words like the or and, you know, words that don't add much meaning to a search.
So it's not just about breaking down the text, but actually making it easier to search through.
Exactly. And this whole process, it's very similar to data pre-processing, which you're probably seeing more and more in the software world these days.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
It's taking raw data and turning it into something that's actually usable and meaningful for your application. And this is a core part of what Lucene is doing with this tokenization and analysis, right?
Yeah, you got it. So now we have our inverted index built from these, you know, nicely prepped ingredients.
Right.
But Lucene doesn't just find matches, it ranks them by relevance.
Oh, right. How does it figure out which results are the most important?
Well, this is where algorithms come into play, specifically things like TF-IDF and BM25. Let's say you're searching for info on space exploration. TF-IDF, it recognizes that the word space is pretty common across many documents, but exploration might be a bit more unique to documents about, well, space exploration.
Okay.
So it'll rank those higher.
So it's not just about finding the key words. It's about understanding what they really mean in a given document and across, you know, the whole set of data. It's kind of like what I'm learning about in machine learning and data analysis.
Exactly. These algorithms are giving you a glimpse into how machines can learn to like extract meaning and insights from massive amounts of data.
This is getting pretty interesting. We're talking about a ton of data here, though.
Mm-hmm.
How does Lucene manage all this information efficiently? It can't just be storing everything in a basic list, can it?
You're right. It needs more specialized structures. One of the key ones is called a finite state transducer, or FST. Think of it like a super optimized roadmap, not just for words, but for like parts of words and how they relate to each other.
Mm-hmm.
This lets Lucene store and search through massive amounts of data incredibly fast while also using minimal memory.
Whoa. So it's like an incredibly efficient filing system for all this text data.
Yeah, precisely. This highlights why choosing the right data structures is super important in software development. The right structure can seriously impact performance.
I'm starting to see the bigger picture here. We've talked about indexing, tokenization, ranking, and now these specialized data structures. It's all about efficiency and making sense of this mountain of information. But what about updates? Like, if the information changes, does the entire index need to be rebuilt every time?
Well, that's where concurrency comes in. The ability to handle multiple things happening at once. Imagine like a library where people could be adding new books and searching for others all at the same time without everything coming to a standstill.
Okay.
That's what Lucene does with its system of segments and merging.
So it can update and search at the same time. How does that even work?
It's like having different sections of the library that are being updated separately and then kind of seamlessly merged together later.
Okay.
This allows for really smooth operation, even if the index is being modified constantly.
That's incredible. And this concept of handling multiple operations concurrently, that's crucial in building responsive and scalable applications, isn't it?
Absolutely. Understanding how Lucene handles this can give you some valuable insight into designing systems that can handle a ton of activity without, you know, slowing down to a crawl.
All right. I'm definitely trying to keep up here, but it's all really cool stuff.
Yeah.
We've talked a lot about like the inner workings of Lucene, but how is it structured on a higher level? Like, what does its architecture look like?
Okay. Well, imagine Lucene as this well-organized toolbox.
Okay.
Each tool has a specific purpose and they work together to get the job done. That's basically Lucene's architecture. It's modular and extensible. It has different components that handle various aspects of the search process.
So it's not just one big mass of code. It's like a set of interconnected building blocks.
Exactly. And this makes it easier to maintain and adapt to different needs. Some of these key building blocks are the directory, document, field, analyzer, index writer, index reader, index searcher, and query parser.
Wow, that's a lot to keep track of. Could you break down what each one does? Maybe use some real-world examples to help me wrap my head around it.
Sure. Let's start with the directory. This component tells Lucene where to store the index. This could be like on your local hard drive, in memory if you need faster processing, or even spread across multiple machines if you're dealing with massive amounts of data.
So it's like choosing the location for a library, a small building, a huge warehouse, or a whole network of libraries.
Exactly. Now think of each book in the library as a document. It's the basic unit of information that Lucene indexes. This could be anything, a web page, a product listing, a customer record, anything you want to make searchable.
So if I were indexing my music library, each song would be a document.
Exactly. And within each document, we have fields.
Okay.
These are specific pieces of information that you want to be searchable, like the song title, artist, album, even the lyrics.
So it's kind of like the entries on a library card, but for our digital documents.
Exactly. And remember we were talking earlier about preparing the ingredients before baking a cake? That's where the analyzer comes in. It takes the content of a field and processes it for indexing. This includes all those tokenization and analysis steps we discussed, breaking the text into words, applying filters, all that.
Oh, I see. So the analyzer is like our meticulous chef who's prepping all the ingredients for our index.
Yep. Now, once the data is prepped, the index writer steps in. This component is in charge of actually building the inverted index. You can think of it as the construction crew carefully assembling all the pieces of our library building.
So it takes all those processed fields from our documents and builds that roadmap we were talking about.
Exactly. And when someone wants to search, that's when the index reader takes over. It reads the index and finds the documents that match the search query, much like a librarian fetching the books that match a patron's request.
I see. It's like all the steps involved in finding information in a library, but done in a split second by a computer.
Yeah.
What about ranking those results, though? Doesn't the index searcher come in there?
You got it. The index searcher uses those algorithms like TF-IDF to determine how relevant each matching document is and helps users find the most important results first. It's like a librarian who not only knows where all the books are, but can also recommend the best ones for you.
Wow, that's really helpful, especially when you've got so much information to sift through. But how does the user actually interact with this whole system? They're not writing code to search, are they?
Of course not. That's where the query parser comes in. It takes the user's search query, usually what they type into a search bar, and translates it into something that Lucene can understand.
Okay.
It's like having a translator who helps the user communicate what they need to the librarian.
So the query parser bridges that gap between human language and the way Lucene understands search queries.
Exactly. And this is another example of how understanding computer science concepts can help you build better software. In this case, it's about making sure your interfaces are user-friendly and intuitive.
This whole layered architecture is really interesting. Each component has a specific role, and they all work together so seamlessly. I can see how this design makes Lucene so flexible and adaptable to different situations.
That's right. And that's one of the key things for software professionals to grasp. It lets you customize Lucene to your specific needs.
It's like having a toolbox and being able to swap out tools or add new ones depending on what you're working on. All this talk about components and architecture is fascinating, but can we see how it's used in real life? Like, how are different industries actually using Lucene? You know, I can definitely see how understanding Lucene can be really useful for building like search features in an application, but are there any other ways it's being used out there in the real world? Maybe some less obvious ones.
Oh, absolutely. One that people don't always think about is log analysis.
Okay.
Think about like all the data generated by servers and applications and websites. It's all logged, right?
Yeah.
For troubleshooting or performance tracking.
Right.
But these log files can be enormous.
Yeah.
It can be a nightmare to find specific information in them.
Yeah, I've definitely spent way too much time trying to dig through log files. Not fun.
Exactly. Well, Lucene can actually parse and index those log files just like any other text data.
Oh, wow.
Makes it incredibly fast to search through them. So you can pinpoint specific errors, track user behavior patterns, even identify security threats.
Oh, that's awesome.
All without manually combing through like endless lines of text.
So it's like instead of searching for a needle in a haystack, Lucene can build like a map of the haystack and tell you exactly where the needle is.
That's a great way to put it. And because you can customize how Lucene analyzes the data, you can tailor it to find exactly what you need in those log files.
That's really powerful. I'm realizing that Lucene isn't just about building a search bar on a website. It's about making any kind of information retrieval easier and more efficient. Are there any other interesting examples of how it's being used?
Well, think about how like streaming services or online stores suggest things you might like.
Yeah.
Those are often powered by recommendation systems.
Okay.
And Lucene can actually be a big part of that too.
Really? I always figured those recommendations were based on like some crazy complex AI or something.
Well, AI definitely plays a role, but Lucene can help by efficiently analyzing user data, like what they've watched or purchased, and content metadata, and even like the relationships between different items.
Cool.
For example, if you listen to a lot of jazz music, Lucene could quickly identify other jazz artists or albums you haven't heard yet.
Oh, I see.
Based on similarities in genre, instruments, or even like what other users with similar tastes are listening to.
So it's using its indexing and search capabilities to find connections and patterns in all that data to make those personalized recommendations.
Exactly. And the best part is it can do this at a massive scale, handling tons of data and constantly learning as new information comes in.
This has been a fascinating deep dive. It's amazing how something as simple as a search bar can be powered by such sophisticated technology and algorithms.
It really is. And for, you know, software professionals who are just getting started, understanding these fundamental concepts can open up so many possibilities, not just for building search features, but for tackling any problem that involves analyzing and retrieving data efficiently and creatively.
I completely agree. Thanks for taking the time to break all of this down. I'm feeling inspired to explore Lucene more and see how I can use what I've learned in my own work.
That's great to hear. And remember, the world of software is all about constantly learning and exploring. So keep diving deep, asking questions, and building awesome things.
I will. Thanks again.
You're welcome.